Anybody right now scared of the coronavirus, right? Y'all ain't scared? Guess what? Why they got all the businesses shut down?
Bring it up.
You understand? They done shut down the businesses. They done shut down the schools. Hey, they scared. You understand? But guess who they ain't scared of? Give me Isaiah 45 and 7.
Bring it up.
They ain't scared of who brought that plague.
Right.
They more scared of the plague instead of the person that brought it.
Right.
That's what they should understand.
Read. Isaiah chapter 45, verse 7.
Bring it up.
I formed the light.
What?
I formed the light.
God forms the light.
Read.
And create darkness.
He does what?
And create darkness.
God creates darkness.
Read.
I made peace.
He do what?
I made peace.
Read.
And create evil.
God creates that evil.
Right.
You know why he creates that evil? Because of our sins.
Right.
Because of our wickedness. He said, he forms the light, he creates evil. You understand why he's bringing that? He said he was going to bring those plagues on us for breaking God's laws. Give me Deuteronomy 28:15. We running around this place, hey, like we're not concerned about why these things are happening.
Right.
Guess what? It's going to happen right in our neighborhoods. And guess what? Our people are going to be dying right in front of us.
Right.
Your mothers, your daughters, your sons, your family, all because our people don't like to take the time to find out why they should fear God.
Read Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15.
Bring it out.
But it shall come to pass, and that will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
God said, if we didn't hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God, guess what? That voice right now is being spoken to you.
Read. To observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day. That all these curses.
All these what?
That all these curses.
God said he was going to bring curses on his chosen people. Read.
Shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
He said, I'm going to put curses on you, and guess what? They're going to overtake you.
Please.
You ain't going to be able to escape these curses.
Right.
Give me verse 60.
Verse 60.
I'm going to show you where the coronavirus is coming from. Read.
Moreover, he will bring upon thee all the diseases of Egypt.
He said he's going to bring all the diseases of Egypt. Read.
Which thou wast afraid of.
Read.
And they shall cleave unto thee.
They're going to do what?
And they shall cleave unto thee.
Hey, if you ain't keeping God's laws, you better be worried about these plagues coming. Read. Right.
Also, every sickness.
Every what?
Also, every sickness.
Yeah, your coronavirus. Read.
And every plague, which is not written in the book of this law, them will the Lord bring upon thee.
He said, I will bring these things upon you.
Right,
he said in Ezra 15, verse 17. Hey, he said he's going to bring these plagues upon us, and guess what? They already locking down the cities.
Right.
They already telling you, they got curfews right here in Columbia.
Right.
They bringing martial law right upon this land.
Right.
And guess what? It's told to you right in this Bible. The Bible is a playbook. It's telling you what's going to happen in these last days.
Right.
It's telling you how you can escape it. He's telling you the playbook of what's going down in these cities. Read.
Hey, 15.
You got a baby on the way? Yeah, guess what? You want to make sure you teach your children this. Hey, you want to bring your child in this world, guess what? You want to be able to lead them in this world so these things don't happen to them.
Right.
Read.
2nd Ezra chapter 15, verse 17.
Bring it up.
A man shall deserve to go into a city and shall not be able.
Hey, listen to this while you walk away. He said a man shall be able to go into a city and what?
And shall not be able.
That's your martial law that's coming to this land. Read.
For because of their pride.
Because of their what?
Of their pride.
Because of their pride. Guess what? Our people are too damn prideful. They don't want to hear the word of God. They got too much to do. They want to run to the stores, get their little weed. Hey, they don't want to hear the word of God.
Right.
Read.
The cities shall be troubled.
The what?
The cities shall be troubled.
Guess what? Clyde, trouble is coming to Columbia.
Right.
Trouble is in Atlanta. Trouble is in New York.
Right.
Trouble is in LA.
Right.
Trouble is in our people right now.
Right.
Read.
The houses shall be destroyed.
The houses going to be what?
The houses shall be destroyed.
Read.
And men shall be afraid.
Men gonna be what?
And men shall be afraid.
Hey, you see the fear in our people right now.
Right.
Riding around with hospital masks on. You know, there's fear among the people.
Bring it out.
Because they don't know what's happening to them. But guess what? God has revealed the truth to the men of God. Read.
A man shall have no pity upon his neighbor.
A man gonna do what?
A man shall have no pity upon his neighbor.
When they cutting off our jobs and men can't eat, guess where they gonna go? They're gonna go into the houses they think got food.
Right? Get out!
And guess what they're gonna do? They're gonna kill for what they want.
Teach!
They're gonna take what they can't get.
Right!
That's what they're gonna do because they living in their wickedness and they don't got love for one another.
Right!
You know why people don't got love for one another.
Teach! We'll
kill each other for stepping on a pair of shoes.
Bring it out!
So what would you think we're gonna do if we don't got food on the table?
Bring it out!
Feed our children. Read!
But shall destroy their houses with the sword.
They're gonna do what?
But shall destroy their houses with the sword.
They're gonna come in with that gun, stake, kill people. For what? For the lack of bread.
Read. Right.
And spoil their goods.
They're gonna do what?
And spoil their goods.
There's gonna be robbing going on throughout our community.
Right. Read. Because of the lack of bread.
Because of the what?
Because of the lack of bread.
Hey. You don't realize, guess what? When you ain't got no job, guess what? You ain't got no money to feed your family.
Right.
He said, for the lack of bread, it's going to be robbing and killing going on in the black community.
That's right.
And for great tribulation.
For what?
And for great tribulation.
How hard is it going to be on our people when we don't got no food? When we can't feed our children? When we're being oppressed by our enemies?
Teach.
Read.
Behold, said God, I will call together all the kings of the earth to reverence me.
He's going to call all the nations of the earth to reverence the Most High. What are you going to do? Read.
Which are from the rising of the sun.
Read.
And from the south, from the east, and Lebanon, to turn themselves one against another.
He's going
to
make them do what?
And turn themselves one against another.
He's going to raise war in this earth.
That's right.
He's going to bring punishment on our heathens. Why?
Right. And repay the things they have done to them.
He gonna do what?
And repay the things that they have done to them.
Payback is coming.
Right.
Payback is coming on our enemies.
Right.
Read.
Like as they do yet this day.
As they do what?
Like this day.
They still oppressing our people.
Right.
Yeah. These man-made plagues by the white man, guess what? The Most High said, I'm gonna bring payback for our people.
Right.
Unto my chosen.
Unto his what?
Unto my chosen.
The blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you find yourself on this side, you're the chosen of the Most High God.
Yeah.
Guess what? You want to call yourself a Christian? You ain't the chosen. His chosen is called Israel.
Right.
We are the Israelites. We are the children of God.
Right.
We must come back to God's laws.
Right.
He's giving you a very simple task. Keep his laws. Read.
Right.
So will I do also. And recompense in their bosom. Thus said the Lord God.
Read.
My right hand shall not spare the sinners.
His right hand gonna do what?
Shall not spare the sinners.
No, they just gonna call on the name and then they gonna be saved.
My right hand shall not spare the sinners.
So guess what? The Most High is telling you, I'm gonna kill sinners.
Right.
So if you wanna stay in your sin, guess what? Death is coming to you.
Hey, right.
For the wages of sin is death.
Right.
So the Most High is asking you to repent from sin. I'm going to ask you one simple question. What is sin?
Bring it out. Bring it out.
What is sin,
brother? Anything out of the line of God.
Anything out of the line of God. And what would that be?
Manly made. Whatever.
Man-made. Hey, brother, let me ask you a question. What is sin?
I like to say, if you know right from wrong, then...
Guess what? These brothers are sitting there selling dope to our people.
Yeah.
They think it's right. They getting paid.
Right.
They getting money on the table. They think that's good. But we're going to tell you what sin is according to the Bible.
Yeah.
That's the thing we do. We come from the Word of God. So guess what? We got to realize we don't even know what sin is. And he's telling you, I'm going to kill sinners.
Right.
Bring it out.
How are you going to escape that if you don't even know what sin is?
Bring it out.
Read.
John 3:4.
Bring it out.
Whosoever committed sin, transgressive also the law.
Whoever commits sin breaks God's law. Read.
For sin is the transgression of the law.
Sin is the breaking of God's laws.
Right.
You understand? Sin is the breaking of God's laws.
Yeah.
So guess what? How can you ever repent if you don't know what the laws are?
Right. Bring it out.
You're going to stay in the midst of sin, and you're going to die.
Right.
That's the reason why God said we must come back. We must be reborn. We have to start over. You understand? So when you say, hey, I'm good, yeah, hey, I know the word, think about it, brother. You didn't even know what sin was. You was heading to death.
Get out,
so guess what? What was your faith in? Your faith was in man.
Right.
Your faith wasn't in this word because you didn't know the word.
Right. No.
You understand? So that's the importance of repenting. To come back, learn God's words so you don't die.
Right.
Give me Baruch 4:1.
Bring it up.
Bring it up.
Understand something. We've been given the greatest opportunity on this earth. And that is to escape death.
Right.
It is an opportunity to go back in rulership, watch our enemies fall, and watch Christ reign, come back into this kingdom and lead this earth.
Right.
You have been given the opportunity to come and be a prophet, a soldier of the Most High God.
Right.
Today is your holy calling. The Most High is calling you. He's begging and pleading for our people to come back to him.
Right.
Read.
Baruch chapter 4 verse 1.
Yeah.
This is the book of the commandments of God.
This Bible is the book of the commandments of God. This is the word of God. This is what he commanded his children to do. Read.
And the law that endureth forever.
How long does the law endure?
And the law that endureth forever.
We're supposed to be keeping God's laws to this very day.
Right.
Read. All they that keep it.
All they that keep it what?
Shall come to life.
They're going to come back to life. They're going to come back into rulership. Because guess what? It ain't no life being a slave in America.
Right.
You know? It ain't no life being oppressed in this world.
Right.
Hey, the only life I want to live is rulership on this earth.
That's right.
That's what we was meant to be. Kings and rulers of this earth.
Right.
But such as leave it.
And such that don't want to keep this law.
Shall die.
They shall what?
Shall die.
They shall what?
Shall die.
Death is around the corner.
That's right.
Death is around the corner.
Dude.
Brother, if you want to live, guess what? You only got one chance. Repent.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.